me. I don't think it's the, like you said, the Kemba one, but outside of family, it's one of the most moving services I've been to. Like, and everyone who spoke to me, you know the difference between. People trying, you know what I mean? Having to find nice things to say, and people who
press pen.
Have not got good things to say. I've got a bloke. Just something decent. Lovely to me. When I started out, proud of myself, actually, you know. It took me 2 years to get to the press. To listen to Ryan. And I came to meet him afterwards. I'll never forget. Stupid, describing myself as an alternative comedian, and he said, there's no alternative, but comedy. You're either funny or you're not witness to you. And for years after, he's one of the guys who's the best. But, I was quite humbled to be invited along. I feel very strange talking to you. I don't know. Somehow I feel like I'm promoting myself rather than going, it was Ken. And look at the turn up today. A lot of people here, I look at the block, and I do love that thing where, you know what I mean, be original. Let's send the service, be original, dedicated. The fact that he didn't know it, you know, he never listened. Somebody who wanders in and out and says, not listen, yeah. He was a people person. If you had waited after gigs, he did miss, and he did handshake, and he did talk to us. And that word, James, you know what I mean, there's a lot of people. We've all gained something from his life and his dedication, his commitment to comedy. But I think it's much the thing when you actually meet the guy himself. And a very sad day, and a really sad day, just say what. As it was said in the legend, it's a thing that's handed out far too easily. But it was.
Can I just ask you how long you were outside that St.
Evans gig? Or how long did you have to wait for it? An hour and a half to meet him. That was after a 4 hour gig. But he had some very good material on Woodward. Because he talked so much, you know what I mean? He had really good local material. I love about the Ken, when you wrote a new gang, you just had him on to rest. He said could have built and built. It was but yeah, I'm sad. You know, and we shouldn't be.
Johnny, is there any aspects of his routine that you maybe use, any lessons that he taught you that you learned?
Oh, Ken was sharp as a tack. You can hear the cogs cranking in my brain when I'm on stage. All I came up with was throwing a song in case you can't remember your next bit of material.